Hello, I'm Tom Shelton, and I'm honored to get to serve in Oldham County as the interim chief financial officer. And I wanted to take this opportunity to explain a little bit about school funding in Kentucky and how that affects us here in Oldham County. To start with, I wanted to explain SEEK, and that is an uncommon term that you might hear as a funding formula for Kentucky education. It actually stands for Support Education Excellence in Kentucky, and it's a combination of both local funding and state funding. This graph shows the amount and the percentages of state and local funding in a comparison from 2008 to 2022. And it shows that in 2008, the state was funding 60% of the cost of education, which is shown here in yellow, and 40% was funded by local school districts. As opposed to this past fiscal year, where the state is now funding only 46% of the cost of education, and local districts are funding 54%. These are state averages, but I want to concentrate on specifically what this looks like in Oldham County. In Oldham County, in 2008, the percentages were exactly equal. The state funded 50% of the cost, and locally here, through our local property taxes, 50% was funded within the county. As of the end of 2022, these percentages have shifted dramatically to 40% is funded by the state and 60% is funded locally through the local property taxes. That plays out very differently across different school districts based on the property values within individual school districts. As I'm sure everyone knows, property values in Oldham County are higher than the state average and are one of the highest in the state. That drives a portion of this difference in the fact that local taxes go up as the value of property goes up. The other thing that happens is if the state does not adequately fund its base of funding per pupil, then it causes a shift like you're seeing here. So what happens is, as we increase the amount of revenue that is received locally through local tax dollars, we get a deduction from the amount that comes from the state through state SEEK funds. Perhaps the easiest way to explain and show this is to look at our previous fiscal year's financial reporting for our district. There's a lot of numbers on this, and so I won't go through all of the numbers on here. But in summary, in our general fund, which is where the majority of our revenue goes, this is where the unrestricted revenues go. Sometimes you hear about the nickel taxes that we pay for facilities that are restricted funds that go into our building fund or capital outlay that are used for construction projects and cannot be used for salaries or recurring expenses. But this analysis is on our general fund, which is where we pay the majority of our employees and where we pay for the majority of our expenses within the district. So in fiscal year 23, that just ended June 30th, we received just under $55 million in local taxes. This is a combination of real estate taxes, personal property taxes, utility taxes, and motor vehicle taxes. We received just under $41 million from state SEEK revenue. So you can see the difference in the fact that the majority of our funding comes from local funds, as I mentioned earlier, as compared to the state. We do have a small amount, approximately 5%, that comes from other revenue sources, donations, contributions, transfers from other funds. But the majority of our funding comes either from local taxes, local SEEK, or from the state allocation. And again, our numbers reflect the fact that locally we fund more of the cost of education than we receive from the state. I also wanted to make sure that everyone understands that we do not send any money to the state. We simply receive less funding from the state because we get the majority of our funding locally. Some people hear of the local effort, which is what is required of us to receive state funding. All local taxes are both levied and received here within Oldham County. All of our property taxes go through the sheriff's office, and all your motor vehicle taxes are paid through the county clerk. And then the utility taxes are, of course, remitted through your different utility bills. If you look at our tax rate breakdown, our tax rate is 81.2 cents for $100 of assessment value. So what that means is a property owner that owned a $100,000 property would pay $812 in property taxes. $200 of that would go directly into our building fund and be restricted for the facilities that I mentioned earlier, directly to be spent on either debt or on construction, and cannot be used for recurring expenses. The remaining $612 goes directly into our general fund. And so I've broken down in two different ways how our money is spent. First of all, I've broken this down by what I call by location. This is where you look at where does the money go within the school district. So 69% of our total monies that go into the general fund, or $420 out of that $612, go directly out to our schools. And then you can see the other expenses as we move across this worksheet to see that there's nearly 6% that comes into the district office, 12% that goes out for maintenance and operations, and just over 7% that goes out for transportation. So this is a breakdown of how our money is spent by location. And this is important because obviously we have to maintain the maintenance and operations facilities and transportation as to take care of our facilities, our schools, and to transport our students to and from school. But by far, the majority of the money is spent directly at the schools, as it should be. At the bottom, you have a breakdown of the type of expenditures that we have in the district. For example, in education, we obviously spend the bulk of our money on salaries and benefits because we have a lot of people that work with the students in our school district. We have nearly 2,000 employees within the Oldham County Schools, so 80% of our money is spent on salaries and benefits. Again, I have a breakdown as you go across to see the other areas of supplies and other types of service expenses. Of course, with the largest two departments in maintenance and operations and transportation of that breakdown. So you can see this breakdown of how we spend our money by type. So we are one of the districts that, again, that has higher than average property values. And so you will always see that the amount of revenue that we generate locally is greater than that we receive from the state. However, due to the underfunding of education in Kentucky overall, we're seeing even a larger disparity of which you saw in the graphs, to where we have the shift to where more and more money is funded locally. And so we always need to advocate that our General Assembly budget and spend more money on education overall at the state, so that this will benefit not only Oldham County, but all school districts. I'm here at the central office and always happy to answer any questions through email or phone call if people have particular issues or questions about this data. Thank you.